Good morning, everyone, and good morning, dear children. Hope everyone is excellent and fine. So, children, education is very powerful. It gives you power to change the world. And in this pandemic, with education, internet has given us more additional powers to come together to get educated live. On this BMC Edu English Standard 4 channel. So children, are you ready to learn a new topic today? Yes, I know you must be fascinating for it. So let us see what we are going to learn today. So kids, our today's topic, BMC Edu English Standard 4, and my name is Srimati Namrata Bhosle. Today's subject is English, Unit 3, Lesson Number 18, and topic is Growing Up. But children, before starting our lesson, let us have a riddle time. So, ears to me, listen carefully to the riddle and give correct and proper answers. All of you, listen very carefully the riddle. You have to guess what am I? You have to listen the question very carefully, and then if you know the answer, do the hand raise and then you give the answer. I have four legs and a tiny tail. I carry my house on my back and I walk very slowly. Come on, children. Guess what am I? Brilliant answer. Very good. That is a tortoise. It has four legs. It has a tiny tail. It carries its house at its back. And it walks very, very slowly. Excellent answer, kids. Let us move to the next riddle. I have four legs with webbed feet. I eat bugs and little fish. I can swim under the water and hop on the land. Come on, kids, guess. What am I?
Frog.
Frog. Very good. Very brilliant answer, kids. It is a frog. Frog is having webbed feet and it can swim under the water. It hops on the land. It eats tiny little bugs. Very good. So let us move to the next question. I have wings, but I am not a bird. I am small and colorful. I live in garden, field, or forest. So come on, buddies, guess what am I? Wonderful. That is a very correct answer. It is a butterfly. So butterfly, it is colorful. It is beautiful. It is flying. It is having wings, but it is not a bird. It is an insect. You can see it fluttering on the flowers in the garden. Brilliant answers, kids. So today, we are going to see two short poems on frog and butterfly. Unit number 3, growing up. Poem number 18, growing up. So first poem, it is short poem and it is about a frog. And the second poem, which you can see, it is about a butterfly. So let's see the poem one by one. Growing up, Mr. Thomas Frog. Little Tommy Tadpole began to weep and wail. So this is a tadpole. Its name is Tommy. It is tiny, little. Its name is Tommy and it is a tadpole. Now children, what is a tadpole? Tadpole, it is a larva of frog having a long tail with no arms and legs. It is a stage in the life of a frog or toad. As you can see the picture over here, it is a tiny tadpole, or you can also call it as baby frog. It is a small baby frog and it has started to weep and wail. Weep means to cry. It is crying. And wail means crying loudly, making sad noise, loud noise. So here, little Tommy Tadpole began to weep and wail. The tadpole named Tommy is crying loudly, making loud noise. For little Tommy Tadpole had lost his little tail. So the reason for his crying, he had lost his tail. The tiny little tadpole is crying, is weeping loudly because he noticed that he has lost his tail. He is missing his tail. He can't see the tail at his back. So the tadpole is crying, is weeping. And his mother did know him as he wept upon a log. So his mother nearby, but she didn't recognize. She did not know that the person who is crying over there is his son only, the tiny tadpole. But she could not recognize it. And he was sitting on a log. Log is a piece of wood. He is sitting on it and he is weeping. So here the word wept means it is to cry and it is the past tense of weep. To cry. And his mother didn't know him as he wept upon a log. For he wasn't Tommy Tadpole, but Mr. Thomas Frog. So the mother did not recognize because it was a little tiny tadpole before. Now slowly it had grown up and the tadpole has become an adult frog. It had grown fully. That is why it is used as Mr. Thomas Frog. The Tommy Tadpole has developed himself into an adult frog. So, Mr., when we call it Mr., means it is used for an adult male. That is why the little Tommy Tadpole's mother did not recognize him at all. That this is my frog, this is my tadpole, my Tommy Tadpole. So children, growing up in this poem, we have seen that Mr. Thomas Frog, before he was a little Tommy Tadpole, and slowly, slowly he had developed into a frog.
As you can see in this picture, these are the stages of growing of a frog. When the adult frog leaves the eggs slowly and slowly develop. It starts growing. So after the eggs, it becomes a tadpole. The tiny tadpoles, they have only a long tail. There is no arms or legs. But later, it develops its arms and legs. As you can see here, its next stage. It is also having a tail here. And it has also developed arms and legs. Again, it is developing itself. It is growing slowly. And it has turned to a froglet. Now, in this picture, the froglet you can see on the leaf, it is having the arms, it is having the legs, but you can see the tail, it is almost vanished. You can see the tail, how long it was, but it has vanished here. And later, the froglet again develops into a frog. So these are the stages of growing of a frog. First, it is the eggs, then the tadpole, then the tadpole with arms and legs, then it becomes a froglet, and finally it grows fully and it becomes a fully grown up adult frog. This is also called as the life cycle of the frog. The adult frog giving eggs. The eggs develop into the tadpole. The tadpole becomes a froglet. It vanishes its tail and again it becomes an adult frog. Again, the adult frog gives the eggs and then it becomes a tadpole. And then the tadpole becomes a froglet and again the adult frog. So this goes on repeating the cycle. That is why it is called the life cycle. So I hope you have understood this first poem. Now let us see the second short poem, which is about the butterfly, the beautiful and colorful butterfly. We all love to see the butterfly fluttering on the flowers. Now let us see what this poem is going to tell us about the butterfly. The butterfly. The fuzzy little caterpillar curled upon a leaf. So children, as you see here in the picture, there is a caterpillar and how it has curled upon a leaf. Now here fuzzy, the word fuzzy is new to you people. So fuzzy means it is covered with soft and fine hairs that are sticky. So this fuzzy hairs or this fine hairs, it helps the caterpillar to stick to the stems or it sticks to the leaves of the plant. So this fuzzy little caterpillar, it has curled upon a leaf. Curled means to wind or to twine. As you can see how it has curled itself on the leaf in this picture. The fuzzy little caterpillar curled upon a leaf, made herself a chrysalis and then fell asleep. So the caterpillar, it stick itself and then later it started spinning a chrysalis. Now this word is also a new word for you people. Chrysalis, it is a stage of life cycle of a butterfly. It is also the name of the hard case or the cover in which the caterpillar lies till it transforms into a butterfly. So as you can see how it is spinning itself, how it is covering itself inside this chrysalis. See, slowly, slowly it is spinning, it is covering itself.
and this is a hard cover. So this stage, it is called as the chrysalis. Chrysalis made herself a chrysalis and then it fell asleep. So after spinning this chrysalis, after making this chrysalis, the caterpillar, it slept inside. It went to sleep. It went on resting mode, you can also say. It rested inside this chrysalis, inside this hard cover. And then what happened? Let us see. While she was sleeping, she dreamt that she could fly. So when the caterpillar was sleeping inside the chrysalis, it was dreaming. As I said, it was resting inside or it was taking a nap. It was sleeping inside the chrysalis. At that time, it was also dreaming. And what it dreamt? It dreamt that she could fly. So in that deep sleep, she was feeling, the caterpillar was feeling that she is flying up in the air. It is thinking the possibility that she may fly. While she was sleeping, she dreamt that she could fly. And then what happened? And later, when she woke up, she was a butterfly. Wow. So look, children. And later, when the caterpillar woke up, when she got up, after having a long duration of sleep, after having her rest, when she came back, she opened her eyes. What she noticed that she has become a beautiful butterfly. And it could really fly now. How beautiful it is. So here also, children, the butterfly poem. It is telling how this fuzzy little caterpillar, how it has transformed itself into a beautiful butterfly. So here also, the poet has presented very wonderfully and shown, it has imagined that what is the butterfly doing or feeling during its growing stages. It is a caterpillar first, then it is curling itself and making chrysalis. And inside that chrysalis, it is like sleeping inside and it is dreaming. And it is dreaming about that she is having some wings and she could fly in the air. So this is also describing about the butterfly life cycle. The adult butterfly gives the eggs on the leaf. The leaves then slowly develops and it then develops into a caterpillar. As you can see, the caterpillar is on the leaf. It eats the leaves and it is growing. Later, it develops a chrysalis around itself and it is resting inside that chrysalis. It is in the resting mode. And inside the chrysalis only, it is developing its wings. Beautiful, colorful wings it is spinning inside. And lastly, it becomes a beautiful butterfly. It comes outside that chrysalis with the wings and beautiful colors. Children, you may also remember in EVS 1, lesson number 1, life cycle of animals, you have also learned the different stages of growing of different animals. Same way, butterflies of various shapes and beautiful colors, they are a part of our environment. They live their life among the plants. As butterflies grow, they pass through 4 stages. As we have seen the stages here also, but these stages are called as, these are the egg, larva, pupa, and the adult.
and the adult stage is called butterfly. So how the caterpillar, it is developing itself, it is spinning a chrysalis around itself. This is the original picture you can see. The caterpillar, it is spinning itself, a beautiful chrysalis, a hard cover around it. And sleeping inside that chrysalis, it is developing slowly, slowly as a butterfly. It is having beautiful wings. And after some days, it comes out of that chrysalis. You can see this transparent thing. That is the chrysalis only. And this is the tiger butterfly, which has come out as an adult butterfly with beautiful wings. And now it can fly as she was dreaming when she was sleeping. So such a beautiful poem it is. And it is very similar to our stages also, children, as growing stages in human beings. First, it is a baby. Then slowly, slowly, human beings also develop. They develop into an early childhood. The early childhood stage slowly develops. And then it is the childhood stage. Then the childhood stage develops. And then we become a teenage, or it is also called as the adolescent stage. And after that, a human being is a fully grown up child or a fully grown up person. It is also called as the adult, fully grown up. So, like how we have our growing stages, same way the animals are also having its different growing stages. So the title is very much suitable to the poem, Growing Up. Growing Up, the title tells us that how the frog is growing slowly, how it is developing slowly. The first poem, it is telling about a little tadpole whose name is Tommy. It began to cry loudly, for he had lost his tail. Then he sat on a piece of wood and cried. But his mother did not recognize him, for now he was no more a tadpole. He was no more a baby frog, but he had grown up and now he was Mr. Thomas Frog. Such a wonderful imagination is done by the poet C.G. Dennis. And in the second poem, we will revise it again in the same way. A caterpillar with soft, fine hair lay curled up on a leaf. She spun a hard covering around herself and then went to sleep. And as she slept, she dreamt that she could fly. Later on, when she woke up, she found that she had turned into a beautiful butterfly. So, children, such a wonderful imagination, such a wonderful two short poems here there are. So let us recite the both poems one by one. Growing up. Listen very carefully. Listen to the words, the pronunciation, and enjoy the poem. Poem number 18, Growing Up. Mr. Thomas Frog. Mr. Thomas Frog. Little Tommy Tadpole began to weep and wail. Little Tommy Tadpole began to weep and wail. For little Tommy Tadpole had lost his tail. For little Tommy Tadpole has lost his tail. And his mother didn't know him as he wept upon a log. And his mother didn't know him as he wept upon a log. For he wasn't Tommy Tadpole, but Mr. Thomas Frog. For he wasn't Tommy Tadpole, but Mr. Thomas Frog. Let us see the second poem, children. recite it with the rhythm. The butterfly. The butterfly. The fuzzy little caterpillar curled upon a leaf. The fuzzy little caterpillar curled upon a leaf. Made herself a chrysalis and then fell asleep. Made herself a chrysalis and then fell asleep. While she was sleeping, she dreamt that she could fly. While she was sleeping, she dreamt that she could fly. And later when she woke up, she was a butterfly. And later when she woke up, she was a butterfly. She was a butterfly. So children, these two fine poems tell us about the changes that takes place in the life of a frog and butterfly as they are growing up, as like you are also growing up. So this frog and caterpillar, how they are growing up. Now children, let us see the rhyming words from these two poems. In the first poem, as you can see, Mr. Thomas Frog, in the first stanza, the first four lines, observe and see the rhyming words. The rhyming words sound similar. Their end sounds are very similar. And it gives a beautiful poetic effect also. So here, in the first four lines, in the first stanza, the rhyming words are veil and tail. Veil and tail. See, veil, tail. The rhyming sounds, the ending sounds are very similar. Ale and ale. So, veil and tail are the rhyming words from the first four lines or the first stanza of the poem, Mr. Thomas Frog. Now let us see the last four lines or the second stanza. Here, the word log and frog. This sounds very similar. The end sounds og and og. They are very similar. So these are the two rhyming words, log and frog, from the second stanza of the poem, Mr. Thomas Frog. Let us see in the next poem, The Butterfly. In the first stanza, the first four lines, the similar sounds you can hear in the words are leaf and asleep. So the last words or the last sounds are nearby similar, leaf, asleep. So here, leaf and asleep are the rhyming sounds or the rhyming words in the first four stanza of the poem, The Butterfly. In the second stanza, the last four lines of the poem, the word fly and butterfly. It is a rhyming word, though the last three letters are also matching here, fly and butterfly. So the sounds are also coming rhymings. So the words fly and butterfly are rhyming words in the last four lines or the last stanza of the poem, The Butterfly. So kids, the rhyming pairs or the rhyming words in this poem are total four words. The pair of rhyming words, first one, veil, tail, veil, tail. Second one, log, frog, log, frog. Third one, leaf, asleep. Fourth one is fly, butterfly, fly, butterfly. So children, we have done this poem. We have revised it again. We have seen how it is. So let us have some questions. This is time for some questions. Just recall what we have done in these two poems. I will ask you the questions. I will give you two options also. You have to select the correct option. So are you all ready for the questions? Let us go then. Question one, who began to wail? I repeat the question. Listen very carefully, children. Who began to wail? Options are a little Tommy tadpole or B, the fuzzy caterpillar.
Little Tommy tadpole.
Very good. Very attentive. The answer is very correct. The little Tommy tadpole. So, who began to wail? The answer is the little Tommy tadpole began to wail. Very good. Let us see the next question. Be ready, children. What did the tadpole lost? I repeat, what did the tadpole lost? Options, his hat or his tail?
His tail.
His tail. Very good. Excellent. He had lost his tail. So what did the tadpole lost? The tadpole had lost his tiny tail, his tail. Brilliant answer. Very good. Let us see the next question. What did the caterpillar made herself? What did the caterpillar made for herself? Option, a chrysalis or a wall?
A chrysalis.
Brilliant, wonderful answer. A chrysalis is the perfect answer for it, as we have seen in the poem. So what did the caterpillar made for herself? The caterpillar made herself a chrysalis, a hard covering. Excellent answer. Let us see the next question. What did the caterpillar change into? I repeat the question. What did the caterpillar change into? It changed into, the options are a bird or a butterfly.
A butterfly.
Fantastic. That is the correct answer. So, what did the caterpillar change into? The caterpillar changed into a butterfly. Fantastic answer. So, children, this is a very interesting homework I am giving you. It is a small activity. You have to present the life cycle of frog and butterfly on a paper plate with the name of its stages. I will show you one sample or an example how you have to make that. I will show you so that you can make similar one showing the stages of the butterfly and the frog in your book. Or you can make it also on a paper plate. So I will just show you. You can see here this one. See, this is the first stage where the butterfly has laid eggs. So you can see the eggs are there on the leaf. Later, I have shown an arrow. You can also show an arrow this way. So that eggs, from that eggs, the caterpillar, it has emerged. And then it has developed chrysalis. It is sleeping inside the chrysalis.
And after the chrysalis stage, it is coming out of the chrysalis. It has developed, it has fully grown up into a butterfly. And here is the butterfly. So this arrows, it can show the cycle of the butterfly. Adult butterfly, it gives the eggs, then it turns into or develops into a caterpillar. It forms a chrysalis, and then it is coming out of the chrysalis, and it again becomes an adult butterfly. So this is the life cycle of butterfly. Same way, similarly, you can make the life cycle of the frog this way. On a paper plate, you can use a paper plate. Also, you can do it in your notebooks. But paper plate, this will also make it look interesting this way. So here also, the adult frog, it has given some eggs. They are little sticky. That is why they are close to each other. Then these eggs develop and it becomes a tadpole. So as we have seen in the poem also, the tadpole. After the tadpole stage, the tadpole is having tail and slowly it has developed its arms. And then it also develops its legs also. And afterwards, it becomes an adult frog. So again, this adult frog will give the egg. It will develop into a tadpole. Then it will develop into a little more growth of the tadpole with arms and the legs. And it will become a froglet, and afterwards it will become an adult frog. So this way you can make on the paper plate showing the life cycle of a frog and the life cycle of a butterfly. So hope you have understood, you have enjoyed this poem, and you will recite this poem as I have recited for you. Okay, children, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe our BNC Edu Standard 4 English channel. Bye, children. See you soon.